So I recently joined an exclusive club. I'll just tell you, I got laid. Off. Yeah, no, I got laid off. Anyway. Hey you guys, gals and ghouls and non-binary boos, it's Cassie with Ghoul Amorous, and I hope you all have been doing amazing! But all jokes aside, I am a part of the 194,000 affected by layoffs, at least according to this article. Today's video is going to be a story time of my experience wrapped up in 6 lessons that I've learned from being laid off. Without much detail, because legal. Now, I do want to say this is not going to be a video where I'm bashing the company or anything. In fact, I'm so grateful for the opportunities. I've learned so much. It was very valuable in my growth. But to be honest, I'm thankful to have had this experience happen to me now rather than later, because I really do think I'm having more of a fun employment. Unemployment? I don't know. I saw it on somebody's post and I just loved it. I don't know how you pronounce it, so take that as you will. Before we jump into it, I love October. Look at my socks. They're Halloween. Anyways, okay, let's jump into it. Lesson number 1, stay informed with your company and department's updates. Now, as far as updates go and you're worried about layoffs possibly affecting you, financials is what you'd want to be looking at. So if your company or your department is meeting the goals that they said that they would, then you're most likely all good, baby, all good. If your financials are not being met and you are concerned about layoffs affecting you, here are some things that you can look out for. The first one being your own work ethic. Are you bringing anything valuable in your scope of work? Are you that impactful in your team or your department? And if so, you probably don't have anything to worry about. But then also think, is your department very valuable? I know that is probably one of the first things that companies look for if they are not meeting their numbers. How valuable is this department or this work? The other things to look at is if you are having internal movement in your department. Through lesson 1 was when I was able to suspect that layoffs may be around the corner and I may be one of the affected. I was doing my best to try to stay informed with the company and department's updates, be it meetings or emails. Despite a mistake I made and I took accountability for, I did my best to make up for it. And then we had movement within the department where another individual that shared the same job title as me came onto my team. So I assumed one of 2 things. Either they are getting promoted or I'm getting laid off, which resulted in the following day, me being laid off. Now, some little tidbits I wish I knew when I got laid off. You do have the ability, if you are being offered a severance package, to negotiate a severance package. And if I find a video, I'll link it down below on how you would go about that. Now, if you're worried about how layoffs may be affecting your job hunt in the future, that companies may look at you and think you were laid off due to your work ethic. If they let you know you were not laid off due to your work ethic, you can request for a letter. I would recommend asking for that letter because on top of that, it would be nice to have to look back and remember, I was not affected due to my work ethic. I was affected due to things outside of my control. But I think this is a great segue into lesson number 2. Prioritize your emotional well-being. Technically, this should be prioritize your well-being overall, but I chose emotional well-being because I feel like if you don't have your mental, your emotional state intact, then a lot of other things in your life is going to fall apart. I know for a lot of people, getting laid off is being blindsided. It's feeling like, I'm not good enough. I didn't do enough. Why me? I know a lot of us tie our worth and our value to the things that we do, our titles, our work. And it's simply not true. It's a part of us, but it's not what makes us up. I didn't realize that was what it felt like for me because I never gave myself the opportunity to feel. For those who don't know me, well, I guess that's all of you, the internet. The internet doesn't know me. Hi, everyone. I'm Cassie. I come from a family of doers. We run on cortisol. We are always drinking coffee. We're just constantly stressed. Action-oriented people. I'm working on it. Now, I will say, leading up to the day I was laid off, I felt so burnt out. And not burnt out from my job per se, but burnt out from just life. I was not pouring into myself in the way I needed to. I was always tired. I wasn't depressed. I wouldn't say that, but I do recall that Wednesday I woke up and I really did feel depressed. And I was sitting at my desk thinking, you know what? I wish I had all the time to just create. I love creating this. And that morning, I got let go. The universe straight up said, say less, bitch. Here you go. Basically, 3 months later, I'm now recording. I'm sorry for that delay. But yeah, I was so relieved. I felt just an inner sense of peace. I will say that the emotions were short-lived. I did not sit into the reality of what being laid off meant and how I felt truly. I just kind of started updating my resume, started sending out applications because the stress of security was on my mind. It wasn't until a few days later I started to feel the reality of being laid off and the narratives that followed, which were, I'm not good enough. Did I deserve this? It was probably because of that mistake I made. I'm so stupid. In reality, that's not true. And like, you can't think like that. You really can't think like that because at the end of the day, things are gonna be out of our control. And the only thing in your control is how you feel, how you think, and how you respond to this outside stimulus. The reason why I stress the importance of sitting in your emotions, allowing yourself to feel them, and addressing the narratives is because one, you deserve to be your own best friend, but two, I started to drink away that emotion to feel something else. I didn't want to feel angry about this. I didn't want to feel, damn, I'm just not good enough for anybody or anything. And in this experience, I've learned that that was a heavy belief, a limiting belief I've had about myself for a good majority of my life. It wasn't until this experience being laid off where I was able to truly be, I am valuable. I am worthy, greatly beyond a job title. But yeah, be mindful in your present reality. Is this serving me? What are my emotions telling me? What is this experience telling me? Is going to be so much more valuable to you and paving the way for your future rather than suppressing, repressing, distracting. But I'll tell you, once you do face the music, you come out so much stronger, so much more capable because you've always been capable. And yeah, I think a little bit more happier too. Not even a little bit, a lot more happier. But if you are worried that you may find yourself not being able to handle this alone, or just you are the type to handle it alone, but the weight of it is starting to get you, the importance of lesson number 3, refine and restructuring your systems. Now, what do I mean by systems? I'm actually talking about 2 systems, and that's going to be financial and support systems. As far as financials go, you're going to want to look at your spending habits. If you don't already know, look at the last 3 months. How you've been spending your money. Is it primarily on eating out? Is it shopping? Is it if you're shopping for necessities or just for fun? Is it experiences? Really get a honus on how you are spending your money. And then you are going to make your new budget. Because you see where you're spending your money, you're also now looking at your monthly, annual, or what have you subscriptions and seeing where you can cut costs. Are you really watching Netflix every day or over Hulu or whatever? Do you really even stream like that? Can you cut it? If you can, go ahead and cut it. If you're sharing it with somebody else, then ask them, hey, I know you primarily use this account. I don't use it or what have you. Can you take over the payment? If they can, great. If not, you've had that conversation. Cut it off. Now looking at your new revised budget, look at your savings. Is your savings enough to cover this new budget? You want to plan as far as you can. Really, it's going to be an ongoing process, but this is for you to explore and to figure out what's important, what matters right now, what can get cut, and cut it. Now I know you're wondering, oh my gosh, I just got a house and I don't know if I'm gonna be able to pay for the mortgage or the rent or what have you. I'm going to tell you right now, ask all the questions. Call all the numbers to ask all the questions and be frank with them. Hey, I just got laid off Can I defer a payment? Can I have a grace period? It really depends on the laws and like the policies each company, each business, each state has, but reach out and ask all the questions. I was able to defer my payments on my debt consolidation, and I'm working on that right now with my student loan. Also, after you have done your financials, definitely apply for unemployment. Just learning about how to go about unemployment, what you need to have in order to be able to get unemployment benefit. I know it's not going to be nearly as much as what you were making before, but something is better than nothing. Again, support system kind of falls in line with lesson number 2, which helps to regulate and manage your emotional well-being. They can also be paired with financials. Can your partner step up to help you financially where they need to? Your roommate even, your family, can you move back in with your family? Does your friend have a space that they could open up for you? They want the best for you and they want you to succeed. I know it's scary asking for help, but again, asking all the questions, asking for help is better than suffering alone. And I don't want that for you. And you shouldn't want that for yourself either. Love yourself, because I love you. I did not have savings. Yeah, because I've been putting a lot of my paycheck into my debt consolidation payments. So that was a fun one, but I'm also very privileged, right? I'm able to live with my parents still. I was actually in the process, me and my boyfriend, we were in the process of getting ready to rent a house, but thank God that I got laid off prior to them, because then I'm sure I would have been fucked. But yeah, my parents have been really kind. They removed the rent that I'm paying until I get a job. So it allowed me to actually bank a lot of my severance. I saw my spending habits. I cut back dramatically. My boyfriend actually stepped up to help take care of me and our little family. And I'm very thankful for my support system. I'd hope that we all have some good support systems, be it family, friends, good relationships with just the landlords or what have you. But if not, I hope that you can go somewhere where you will have that support. Lesson number 4, reflect, plan, and act. Now, what do you mean by this, Cassie? What the hell? I think there's a ghost in my house. Boo, bitch. Anyways, now what the hell does reflect, plan, and act mean? Now that you have more of a stable emotional well-being, a stable sense of self, I mean, I hope your sense of self is always stable. Don't be like me. But basically, you've settled into the reality and it's not affecting you as much. This lesson is really about taking stock of your reality, what you are happy with, what you are not happy with, and making those changes in accordance to who you want to become, the life you want to live, the career you want. And this is how you're going to do it. By reflecting, you're reflecting on what works, what doesn't work, what lights me up, what doesn't light me up, what are the pros and cons of X, Y, and Z. What did I like about my company that I worked for? What didn't I like? Well, about my department, about my team, about my scope of work. And not even just this last job or career, but the ones prior to it. If you find common threads within all of them, be it good or bad, you can make that change, right? You don't have to go back to it. You find, damn, I'm tired of marketing, or damn, I hate IT. You can then decide, can I pivot? And then you plan. I'm ready to pivot, or I'm ready to further my career. You're gonna plan and think, can I go for these certificates? Can I further my education by enrolling in this college? What do I need? Do I need to pull out a loan? Are there even classes offered for free? Are there games on the internet that I can learn coding? Like, what have you? Once you've figured out that plan, or not even, it can be used in conjunction. While you are planning, you are acting. But if you don't want to act just yet because you're like, oh, well, I'm a little nervous, it's okay. You are just going to act after based off of that plan. I'm now going to enroll in this college. I am now signing up to get the certificate. I'm going to test for this. This is a video about being laid off from a job or a career, but it can be applied to anything. Dang, I didn't like that type of workout, but I love this type of exercise. I'm going to keep doing this exercise because it makes me feel good about myself. I hate that this food makes me feel this way. I'm going to change what I eat. It can be applied to anything. Live your life. You deserve it. Live your best life. Speaking of how reflect, plan, and act can be applied to every aspect of your life, lesson number 5 is so important, and that's to do things for you. Now that you have all this time freed up to do you, basically, spend it wisely. Be intentional. I started to work out. Well, okay, I'm taking a break from it. I threw my back out because I got laid. I'm kidding. I threw it out because I did RDLs wrong. But I started picking up yoga and it's been helping with my mind, my mental clarity, my emotional regulation. I've been playing video games again, which has been fun with reconnecting to my inner child. I finished Hogwarts Legacy. I was playing Animal Crossing. I don't think I'll ever finish my island, but that's still a hope I wish to achieve. I've been spending more time with friends and family and going out in nature, just basking in the sunlight. I will say I realized the importance of structure for me. I know, crazy, ADHD person with structure. ADHD people do require structure. It's just a little bit of a chaotic structure, okay? But yeah, having the time to really focus on myself and be conscious in what I do has allowed me to step into myself in a way that I've been needing to for so long. And I feel a lot more happier. And I just want you guys to be happy too. This is a time that can be used for you to live your best life, of course, within your means, just developing good habits and breaking habits that don't serve you anymore. Use your time wisely. That's all I will say. And when all is said and done, I'll leave you with lesson number 6, trust and have hope. These times can be very hard and uncertain and scary. I know if you're going in like 6 months, 8 months, a year or more, that hope over time can dwindle. But believe in your hope. Believe that you are deserving, that you are capable, that you are worthy. When you believe those things about yourself, it shows in your interviews. We're gonna have the right thing come to us in time when we do find it, when we apply, or when somebody reaches out to us. And the best way to do that is by having hope and trusting in yourself. Knowing what you're bringing, trusting in your capabilities. You're freaking badass. You are. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. By trusting in yourself and acting in accordance, the universe will make it happen. Your God will make it happen. Your higher power, whatever, it will happen. But yeah, that's 6 lessons I've learned in my time being laid off. I hope they've helped you in some way, shape, or form, at the very least, feel less alone if you were affected. And if you were affected, actually leave a comment down below letting me know a lesson or takeaway that you've had from your experience. If you liked this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already, click the subscribe button. I'd love to see you again. I'll leave you all with this. As I always do, be kind to yourself, be kind to others, and live with intention. See ya.